Hey guys, Pat Washit here, and I would like to start off the video saying a very big thank you to all of you who have been sticking with me and subscribing. Lately, I've been losing subscribers, and also gaining subscribers, and I don't know if it's because of my shift from Counter-Strike Source to Team Fortress 2, or that there's other videos I've done, for example, tutorials and Splinter Cell recently. And I don't know if that's scaring people off. So I would like to ask your opinion, guys, about what you would like to see from me. What do you expect? Are you expecting me to stick to Team Fortress 2, you know, solely? Or would you like me to wander off sometimes and play other games? Because, you know, I've already done Splinter Cell. I already pre-ordered Battlefield 4. So I'm expecting that to come out in late October. And on top of that, my friend Lawyer Cop, who's part of my team, he suggested to play Alien Swarm, and he's found a whole bunch of map packs to play, like custom maps. So I'd like to record that sometime, but the issue is, again, I don't want to lose you guys if you think that I'm going to be posting other games. So I just would like to hear your opinion on this, and, you know, I can go either way. But for right now, as you notice, I post some different games out there, but then I come back to Team Fortress 2. So I don't want you guys thinking that if I post a different type of game video, that I'm not going to go back to Team Fortress 2. Of course, I will go back to Team Fortress 2, but that's my main base right now. Secondly, for this video, I want to also talk about a lot of other stuff for the future of my channel and stuff. And I've noticed recently that I am about, I would say, 12 subscribers away from 1,900 total. And I want to give you guys a reward, if you want to call it that. If one day when I do get to 1,900 subscribers, I'd like to do like a really short animation of the Demo Man dancing to, what's the band called? Bee Gees. And as you know, I've done the Demo Man pants, the bell bottoms, and I wanted to have the Demo Man dance to some Bee Gees music with those nice sparkling bell bottom pants. So I don't know if that's a huge incentive, but it's something I'd like to do as, you know, something for fun and also for practice on my end for animation. So for this video, though, if you don't recognize it, it's perfectly fine. My friend Crespi introduced me to this as well, and also the rest of my team, and it's called Ulti Duo, U-L-T-I-D-U-O, and what it is, as the name suggests, it's two people on each side, one medic and one soldier, and it's a King of the Hill map, and both teams have a total of 5 minutes. First team to reach zero, you know, for the seconds, wins. And the reason why I'm showing this is not only to introduce you guys as well to this game type, but also the ending is pretty epic for me, because the ending was like, I don't know, we were both on, I can't remember if we were on overtime or they, or the other team was on overtime, but we were on overtime for a while, and it lasted for like, I would say about a minute, maybe a minute and a half. And the other team consisted of my friend Crespi and Teyoti. Crespi was a soldier, Teyoti was the medic. Here I am on, for my team, I'm playing soldier, and my friend Tornado is playing medic. So we are just, you know, practicing, we are off-classing, and we're trying to develop, you know, a better bond and teamwork, you know, so we can apply this when we do matches for Highlander. So, you know, we're just having fun, and that's the best part about this game type, is all of us are having fun. And, you know, we learn from our mistakes, we, you know, come to the same Mumble channel, and we talk about what we did, what we think we could have improved on and stuff, and it just, you know, it's overall a very fun experience, in my opinion. So, and if any of you want to join me in Ulti Duo, we have our own private server, which is what we're using in this video. And you guys, I have no issue with you guys if you guys want to play with me, Pubs, or Ulti Duo in this case. Please message me, please comment below. I have no issue with that. I'm very open-minded to people. If people are curious about learning more about Team Fortress 2, I can do with the best of my ability to help you out, and that's why I'm here. And I'd like to change the subject to go on to the, for the future of my channel, I would like to First off, of course, do more Team Fortress 2 videos. And the main, I would say the main consumption of my channel would be for matches. You know, when I do Highlander matches with my team every week. And for this season 11 for Highlander, we are going to be playing all the way up to December of this year. And so that's roughly estimate 3 months, I would say. So every week for the next 3 months, I'll be posting the highlights of the match. And even if I do really poorly, I'm still going to post. Because I want to explain what happened. I want to tell you guys what I've done wrong. And also it does help me out as well, because I'm watching my replay of my match. And I'm like, oh, so that's what I did wrong. You know, or, oh, that's what I can improve on. And if anyone else there out there plays Spy, maybe you can learn from my mistakes, and hopefully you won't repeat them in your matches or your scrimmages or pubs or whatever. So, and then the next type of videos I'll be posting as well is just fun scrimmages, you know, like just with teams. Just like my very most recent video I just published yesterday, last night, I was showing the scrimmage between 5th and my clan, Atzel Not. And, you know, it's all about recording. For me, it's all about recording them and showing you guys what I'm doing. So I want to try to help people out there who don't know much about Spy. And the other types of videos I'll be doing is just regular fun pubs, you know, playing on public servers and working with my teammates. And most of the time, public servers require off-classing, like playing medic or soldier, demo, and the list goes on. And my last type, I don't know if this will be important or popular, but I'd also like to do tutorials. And I've recently done some 3DS mats tutorials for you guys, and I will be doing more shortly. I can't promise a due date yet, but I'll be doing more. And I've been trying to post my YouTube videos on the Steam guides for Team Fortress 2, because they get publicized and hopefully people will see them. That's my whole expectation of this. And again, if you guys have any questions about these tutorials, like how to import stuff, or if you guys want to request a certain type of tutorial, please let me know. I'm very open-minded. I'm always open to doing different stuff, and even if it's a subject I might not know much about, I'll do my best to help you out by either replying or saying, oh, I'll make a video on that, and research before I make the video or reply. So, and finally, for my channel, as I've already stated in the very beginning, I would like to do other games, you know, for this channel. And again, I want to let you know, I will not give up Team Fortress 2. I'm not going to be doing one video. The only thing I can give you a heads up on, when Battlefield 4 comes out, I most likely will be posting videos for that for maybe a week straight. Because, you know, when the game is fresh, you know, everything's hot, everyone's looking for those games, in this case, Battlefield 4. So I wanted to post those types of videos out on my channel, so hopefully it would get more, I would get more traffic to my channel, and that's my whole goal right here. And so, yeah, I mean, I would greatly appreciate you guys to give me some feedback here. Maybe just request a certain type of video you want to see, or a class you want to see me play as, or a map, you know, and whatever you can think of. I want you guys to feel involved with my channel. I don't want you thinking that, oh, I'm the dictator here, I do what I please and that's it, I have the final say. So no, I want you guys to feel appreciated and involved. So yeah, just please, I'm very interested in hearing everyone's opinion about my channel and what you want to see, or maybe something you want to see changed of what I'm doing. But overall, I mean, this is pretty much the premise of my channel, and I want people to subscribe to my channel not because I forced them to or because I asked them to. I want people to subscribe because they enjoy watching my videos. That's what I'm trying to achieve here. So anyways, before this video ends, I want to kind of talk about this video real quick. And what's great about AltiDuo, or what I love about it, is it's 2v2, and it's pretty much MGE. I recently did a tutorial on that maybe a month or so ago, and it's pretty much one-on-one except you have a medic. And it teaches you how to not only focus on the opposite soldier, but it also teaches you how to work with the medic and make sure he or she doesn't die. And it's all about teamwork with this. And again, as I said before, it's a great team building map and also arena style match. And I absolutely love this. I try to play it every night. I know I might be overdoing it, but I just love it. I've been playing this for about, I would say, 2 months now. And thanks to Crespi, I mean it. Crespi, he's been mentoring me. He's been doing a great job of mentoring me. And it's taught me a lot, and my team has definitely improved, especially with my communication. For example, when I die, whoever killed me, I would tell them, I would tell my team member, say, hey, so-and-so killed me, and she has this amount of health left. So it teaches you, okay, when you die, tell them how much health they have, and maybe if, let's say, you're playing soldier, your medic will whip out the crossbow and try to snipe them. But the farther the distance the arrow travels, the more health it will give or the more damage it would give. So it's a great tool to use in Alti-Duo, especially when someone's on the point and they need health and you're far away. So the medic could stay in spawn, snipe your opponent or snipe your teammate to give him health, and then whatever other strategy you have in mind, you can do. So that pretty much sums it up for this video and also the future of my channel. Again, please, I would love to hear from you guys. So I definitely appreciate you guys subscribing, watching my videos, liking my videos and stuff. So again, it's not going unnoticed on my end. I am very humbled by this. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this. And I look forward to posting more Team Fortress 2 videos soon, especially that 3DS mats tutorial. Number 2 will be coming out shortly with shortcuts and beginner modeling tips. So, again, thank you for watching, guys. Bye-bye.